in your spirit to stop you from progression. But I'm here to tell you today that we're going to bust up the demon of fear. And you're going to make it over to the other side. You will be elevated. You will overcome this season. Through the power of the Holy Ghost. Nothing is going to stop you from achieving what God has ordained for you. I want you to give God some praise right now. Somebody say hallelujah. When it's time to make a change, when it's time to do something different, the Bible said, suddenly, behold, I'll do a new thing.
Yes.
And the Lord is getting ready to do something brand new in your life that you never experienced before. Some of you have been praying for change. And now that God has presented a door before you, you are trying to rationalize why you shouldn't walk through the door. But I'm here to tell you now that faith is unquestioning belief in God. Faith says that I'm going to stand no matter what I see, no matter what I feel, no matter what I heard. I'm going to make a move no matter what. And I want you to know in Hebrews 11:1, the Bible declares, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So in other words, faith is established conviction in unseen things. What that means is that if you can see it, it's not faith. But faith is grasping on to something that you can't see. It means to stand in expectation. It means to look for, to long for, to anticipate. Amen. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, you're going to make it through. Wow. Your season of change.
Tell her, come here for
a minute. See, what's important about change is that we need to be concerned about purpose. Season, purpose, and time. Amen. We are in the time of elevation. Tell your neighbor, the time is now.
The time is now.
Oh, you're here now.
Well, get that.
God is talking to you right now.
Watch. Move your finger.
It's on you gotta make a move right now. So, Father, we just thank you, Lord God, for every vessel that's here right now. In the name of Jesus, we take authority over the spirit of fear, anxiety. We bind up doubt, skepticism, and unbelief. We bind up every spirit that will come to dispatter the people of God from moving forward to destiny. I'm here to tell you that you're in your season of elevation. I said God is going to open up a new door of elevation on your behalf. Some of you are standing right in the face
of
a new door. All you need to do is activate your faith. You need to just believe God. I want you to begin to say, I believe God no matter what. No matter what it feels like, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it sounds like. I'm trusting and believing in God. I will not be afraid. I want you to know that when we talk about crossroads are times and seasons in our life, amen, where we have to do something different. And many times there are crossroads in our lives as we mature, amen. Some of us have to change the way we eat. Some of us have to change the way we think. We have to change the way we handle our business. We have to change the way we're dealing with God. Now, I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about relationship. And God has called for each and every one of us to have a relationship. Some of us need to take the limits off of God. We have God in a box. And God has said, you know not what I'm doing in your life. Stop trying to figure it out because I've already worked out the strategy. You just need to come before me so I can give you instructions that will cause you to complete, amen, what you're doing right now. I hear the Lord saying that this season of change is going to take you into a new dimension of faith, a new dimension of prosperity. I hear the Lord saying that many of you here have a business acumen, and God has been dealing with you about taking your business to the next level. But you're trying to figure out, I don't have the money. And God said, I didn't say said, don't allow fear.
Don't allow fear.
Anxiety.
Anxiety.
Mind binding.
Mind binding.
Mind blinding.
Mind blinding.
Jealousy.
Jealousy.
Anger.
Anger.
Rejection.
Rejection.
To hinder you.
To hinder you.
From moving forward.
From moving forward.
Somebody give God some praise. Fear is worry. I know there's some people here, you've been dealing with anxiety. There's some of you here, you've been dealing with the spirit of death, where you can't sleep at night. There's some of you here, you feel like you're smothering. Nothing is changing. If that's you, I want you to stand up right now. If I called out anything, you in panic. You know you gotta make some changes, but you don't know what changes to make. You know you're just sick and tired of being sick and tired, and something has got to be done differently in your life. There's some of you here, you're just angry. If you're just angry and you don't know why or how you got to this point in your life, I want you to stand. I want you to stand. I want you to come right here, those of you, so I can pray for you now. Because this spirit of fear is going to be destroyed. Maybe they can just sit in the chair so no one's going to fall or anything. Just turn these chairs around. Hallelujah. I want you to say, no more fear. I'm walking by faith.
I'm walking by faith.
In my season of transition.
In my season of transition.
Amen?
Amen.
Come on and give God some praise. Yes. I need y'all to just praise God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. All of you here, there's a door of ministry. There's a door of ministry before you. And some of you have feared the responsibility that comes with the call upon your life. But I hear the Lord saying that he's going to increase your faith. And the things that you're dealing with naturally, once you walk through the door, it's going to be eradicated. As a matter of fact, you're in a faith test right now. God's been trying to build your faith. And it's like a cycle. But today, the cycle is being destroyed. Father, I thank you for the woman of God. I thank you for breaking the cycle, destroying the cycle. I thank you for opening up, Lord God, her eyes, opening up her heart, that she may walk through the door with no hindrances. I give you praise now for the spirit of liberty. I want y'all to bless God for her. I thank you for faith to answer your call of ministry. I thank you for faith, to answer your call of ministry. I thank you for faith, oh Rabasa. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God want to use you in this vineyard. You in the kingdom. You can travel anywhere.